Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel. My name is Prosper Odono from Pokans Institute of Craft and Creative Arts. So today I want to teach you how to make a bonnet cap, also known as shower cap. So today I want to teach you how to make a shower cap. So I have all my materials needed. As you can see, I have my my fabric. What I'm going to use is like a poly nylon that I have been using for shower as in raincoat. So that is what I use it for. But I'm going to use it for shower cap. It has two sides, two colors. So that is it. I have my elastic. I have what I will use to design the edge, because I'm not doubling it. So I'm using one. It has double color. So I just use that orange to design where I will fix my elastic. So let's get started. So once again, please subscribe to my channel if you've not done that already. If you are new, welcome. If you've subscribed already, thank you for your subscription. And please always give the video a thumb up and always share my video to others. Thank you. So the first step, I folded my fabric two folds, that is, fold it first, then fold it again from the edge. So this is what I have. So it's in four now, four. So I have four ply already. So now what I'm going to do is to use my tape. I'll measure from here to here 11 inches. From here to here is 11. You can make your own 11.5, 12, 10, 10.5. Whatever you want it, but this one is just going to be average. If you want it to be very big, you can even make 14, 13. So, but this one, I'm measuring 11.1. Yes, 11.5, I mean. 11.5. So, from here to here, I place my tape. I get 11.5. I place my tape this way again. From this edge here, make sure your tape is at this edge. Then you place it to 11.5. You go this way, 11.5. So you now mark it this way. So this is how it's going to be, your 11.5. So that is how it's going to be. So there is it. Once again, you fold your fabric. Then whatever you are using, this side is like nylon, or this side is like a lining, thick material. So, but that is what I want to use, because I'm using it for shower cap. So from here, this edge here, so this point here, 11.5, 11.5, 11.5, 11.5, 11.5, and go around to get your circle. So that is what you want to do. Okay, so this is what we have. After cutting it out, we get this. So this is what we have. You can see it now. So when you open it, you have this large circle. This is what you get. A very massive circle like that. So the next step, you measure your head circumference, and mine is 23. So when you measure it, you will use it to cut your elastic. So that is it, you use it to cut your elastic. And what I'm going to do now, I'm going to, if you want to use double, if you want to double it, maybe you are doing a bonnet for like just satin that has double layer, you have to get this material. You have to measure this fabric two, like this one. Now you are going to do two of it. So by the time you do two of it, you now use it, you now place one wrong side to wrong, right side to right side. Any side, this one, it has double face. So for any side you want to use as the right side, so you are going to place it right side facing right side, then you stitch it around, then you leave in a space for turning. So by the time you turn it, you now sew it, match it down, and you use that space to fix your elastic. So I'm coming, but this one is just going to be one, because it's shower cap and this side is like poly. So this side, water cannot go through it, but this side is soft. So I want to use it for shower cap. So that is it. You can use it also for your bonnet cap. You can use it for any other method you want to use for. So this is what I've done. This is what I have to use my webbing in bag making Nigeria way. We call it a taping. So that is what I use. So it's webbing that I use, this soft one, very light type, because there are different types. So this is the light type, and you can use what is it called? You can use a bias tape. Yes, you can use bias tape. We call this one taping. So what I did, I just take it and I use it to run around this. So this is what I've done. I have a run around the circle using this. Attach it first and cover it up. So the next step now is my elastic. My head circumference is 23. So I just decided if it's 23 to be too loose, so I cut my elastic 20. So I just, this is 20, this is 20, I cut this 20. So I've attached my pin to it, so I'm going to pass it through and then place it there, and that will be our bonnet cap. So this is our shower cap. So this is it. So this is how it look like. So what I did, I after attaching this, then I cut my elastic 20 inches, because my head circumference is 23, so I just minus 3 so that it will not be too loose on me. Since it's elastic, it will draw. So that was what I did. I now use my pin to fix it in the space I left here. So this is it. After fixing it in, and I'll sew it here. So that is it. So we are done. That is how to make your bonnet cap. If you want to make it shower cap, whatever, but this particular one is shower cap with this design. Thanks for watching. Please, if you've not subscribed to my channel, please subscribe to my channel and follow me on WhatsApp. Our WhatsApp group where we do online training, you will see the link. I'll post the link here. Also, our Instagram page, Prosper Odono, at Facebook, Prosper Odono, and our channel, our parents' channel, Bokan's group, and subscribe to this channel. And please just click the bell button so that by the time we subscribe, you will see, by the time we post new video, you will see our video. And please subscribe and share to friends, share my videos. Thanks for watching. See you in our next video. Bye bye.